In this video, I'm going to show you how to use coroutines to run a one-shot operation and show it on screen via live data. I'm not going to explain why I'm using coroutines or live data in this video, but I'll leave some introductions in the video description. In this app, I'm exposing a live data called weather from a view model as I showed in a previous screencast. Let's open our view model. We're exposing a live data with a hard-coded weather report. Rainy would work for London, but other cities may have different predictions, so we'll get the data from an API instead. In this dummy weather API, we have a method called fetchWeather, which is a suspend function. This object will replace a retrofit call or a room DAO or anything that supports suspend functions. One way to call coroutines from ViewModels is to use the ViewModel scope. We could write something like ViewModel scope.launch and simply assign the mutable live data's value to a hard-coded string first, and then, when ready, to the result from the API call. If we run the app now, we can see it works as expected. However, there is a lot of boilerplate, so instead, we're going to use the LiveData coroutine builder. You'll find it in the Lifecycle LiveData KTX module. The LiveData builder creates an immutable LiveData, so we don't need a backing property anymore, and the init block can also go away. Inside the LiveData block, we are in a coroutine, so we can now call suspend functions. We use emit to send updates to the observers, so we can start with a loading string, and then we call our API. If we run the app now, we'll get the same behavior, but in just 3 lines of code.